Good evening, and sorry to hold you back after a long day's discussions, but we'll keep it very brief. The objective here is to introduce you to a distinguished guest who is visiting us today. Professor Pradeep Verma currently works for MHRD on the National Mission. In fact, he was one of the conceptualizers of the National Mission. He has come to IIT Bombay primarily in the context of discussion on how to take the Aakash tablet work for the future, but also about the other projects that are going on here. When I told him that we have this workshop going on and we have over 50 enthusiastic senior faculty colleagues who want to take computational fluid dynamics across to the country, so I just thought we'll have a small chat. Please feel free to, I'll request him to say some few words, opening remarks on the nature of the work that he does and what is his own conceptualization of the dream over the next 5 years. Where does he want to see the Indian higher education system to go? And then we'll have a brief interaction, any questions from you, etc., etc. And then we'll wind up, maybe another 20 to 25 minutes, I hope that is okay. So, by the way, also let me tell you, he is a teacher with a difference. He comes to teaching line from a huge work in Indian IT industry. So he used to dabble with large IT systems. He was at one time head of Asia Pacific and Middle East for a company called Mises. I don't think many of you would have heard that. Mises was a high-end banking software, which before the emergence of things like Finacle from Infosys and iFlex, before these systems even came up, Mises was the most used banking software in the world. He used to head that group here. But somewhere, the teacher in him said, I must get out. He's been teaching at Terry, has been teaching courses in management at IIT Kanpur, Delhi, MDM Gurgaon, etc., etc. So he's primarily a management expert, not an engineer like us. And as I said, for last several years, almost right from the conceptualization of the National Mission on Education using ICT, he has been involved from the conceptualization to detailing and continues to be involved further.
So good evening. As Professor Phatak said, the intention is not to take up your time unnecessarily. I am primarily, my main interest today is to hear from you, your experience about this workshop, and if there are any questions about the National Mission on Education or about Aakash. Aakash, have you heard about Aakash? I don't think there's anybody in the world who has not heard about Aakash by now. There's so much has been written and spoken about it. So Aakash is that low-cost access device which is being designed and manufactured in India by and for the government of India, the Ministry of HRD. It's a project that has been funded by the Ministry of HRD, by this National Mission on Education through ICT. And Aakash is a project that is now going to be handled by Professor Phatak and Professor Kannan and IIT Bombay. So we have great hopes of our vision in the future regarding Aakash being actually worked out and brought to reality here at IIT Bombay. Are you aware of the National Mission on Education through ICT? Are you aware of NMEICT? Some of you are. So that's great. So I won't waste or spend more time talking about NMEICT unless there are specific questions. This format of the workshop that Professor Phatak and his team are doing is something that has proved very useful, and that's the feedback that we are getting from across the country in all the workshops that have been held. So I'd like to hear from you, what has been your experience?
Basically, like to thank you, MHRD, and the entire team who is behind this project. Basically, the main or the very prime, what we can say, we get the opportunity to interact with the very eminent professors from IIT. Otherwise, we are staying at very remote places, and from our busy schedule or our day-to-day activities, we don't get a chance to come to IIT and to interact with them for a period of, let's say, for 5 days or 6 days. And they are really stalwarts in their respective fields. So that's the very important advantage we see that we got from this project. And the teachers who already gone through this, either we have conducted two workshops at our end, applied thermodynamics and heat transfer. So teachers are really very happy, and for last two workshops there were around 35 people, 40 people enrolled at my center, Cummins College of Engineering, Pune. And this time, this is a computational fluid dynamics. It's a hot topic. So we expecting more than 40 participants in this time.
So are you in touch with those teachers who go back to their colleges by any chance? Do they touch base with you, or their relationship is only transactional? Once they come, they go away.
No, no. They are eager to attend the next workshop. So the almost 90% of the people who attended thermodynamics, they came back for heat transfer.
Okay.
The only request from their side is that we had a workshop about applied thermodynamics, heat transfer, and this time computational fluid dynamics. So people from design stream are really expecting some workshop.
So Atul, you can carry back this feedback. Yes.
So I have a question. You say that many people are would have already attended in the past.
Yes.
Do you think it will be possible for us to ask them how they have used the previous courses?
Yes, definitely, sir.
That whether the students benefited?
Yes, sir.
Or they benefited, or if they could significantly improve to their normal teaching methodology by attending this workshop.
Yes.
At the end of the day, that is what is important, isn't it?
Yes.
What about you? You yourself have been involved.
Yes.
Now, when you teach courses at your place, you must have been doing it continuously.
Yes.
Do you find that there is a subtle value addition to you yourself when you teach those courses?
Of course, sir. I attended the workshop by Professor Gayatonde. So that gave me entire different insight about thermodynamics. So whatever we are reading from the books and etc. So entire different flavor he has, like first law of thermodynamics. He had taught us very different way. Of course, every 100% we cannot transfer it to the students, because whatever the kind of students we get, they may not digest that kind of concepts whatever he taught us. But definitely we can teach them in different aspect, and there is a lot of improvement in our knowledge, in our teaching.
So it does help in the
helps a lot, sir. It helps a lot.
Thank you so much. I would just also like to mention, now that he has let the cat out of the bag, I was avoiding mentioning that we may be handling the Aakash project, because formally we had not. I am just told that today the minister has made an announcement in parliament that the project will be handled by IIT Bombay now instead of IIT Jodhpur. So what I wanted to tell you is, one of the suggestions which I have made, of course that yet to be discussed with MHRD, but I've discussed it with him, that we are also expected to do field deployment test of Aakash. Now, one of our objectives is to try and put Scilab on Aakash. The second objective is to give access to educational content such as video recorded lectures and other etc. using Wi-Fi connectivity. Now, one of the suggestions I have made is that each of the remote centers of this program, which is constantly in touch with 50 other teachers, and they themselves conduct these courses in their own institutions, should be given 100 to 150 Aakash tablets for actual field testing in one of the courses which they teach. And preferably that course should be one of the courses for which you have coordinated here, etc. And then in that particular subject that you teach, we would expect you to use the Aakash tablets in the context of enhancing the educational value of that. And of course, we'll leave those there. What will be expected is, during such workshops in future when they are conducted, which will be during vacation time, you will make those tablets available for participants of that workshop. Remaining academic year, you can use them. It's not a very large number, but do you think you will be able to use them effectively? Okay. Any other comment?
Just to add to what Professor Phatak has said, the objective, of course, is to help you in by giving the Aakash tablet, is to help you in your own teaching, as he said. But from our point of view, one major objective is also to get feedback on the tablet. Okay, how have you used it? What problems did you face? And what is particularly interesting in a group like this is it's from different parts of the country. So we want feedback on usage in different climatic conditions. Some of you are from places where it rains a lot. Some of you may be from places where there's a lot of dry heat, say Rajasthan or something. Yeah. So in different climatic conditions, how does it respond? Does it freeze? Does dust trouble it? Does high temperature or high humidity? Although we will have done all those tests in the lab, it'll go through a series of lab tests, but actual usage is something else, and that is what we want to understand. Also, you might like to, you know, give it to some of your students for an hour or 2 hours, because this, the way a student would use it is different from the way a teacher will use it. A student may want to, you know, maybe play a game and see how it works or something. So all that feedback is of great value to us, and that we will set up a system where some kind of feedback form and all will be there. But that my request to you is to enable us to get that feedback. And that feedback will cycle back into the next development of Aakash. It's critical, the thing that you will, the role that you will play.
Well, I just wanted to give them the good news that we are planning to give them tablets. The amount of work that they will have to do will be specified later. But then this is the standard IIT style and they are all aware of it. The quizzes will come after good lectures. All. So another aspect is that we also want some students from your own computer science and IT departments in conjunction with you and other colleagues to actually develop additional applications, additional contents, etc. That's why I suggested the number 150, that about 100 would be used in a course that you teach. So those 100 units could be given to those students for that semester. And we'll even put the attendance application, quiz conducting application, etc., etc. But 50 should be preserved for to be given to the final year project students who will do projects on additional applications or contents. So that's the idea. What Professor Kannan suggested is let's use this opportunity quickly to get some more feedback, like our friend gave, from the experiences of other centers. Like he's from Pune. Is there somebody here from some?
My name is Karthik. I am from Amruta School. I conducted thermodynamics workshop as a coordinator. When I started my career, I just want to add this point to what he said. When I started my career, even though I did M.Tech with a good score, I came out from my college, I was stranded how to teach thermodynamics. When I went to my colleagues or went to my senior teachers, they said something, but I am not sure. But because of this conference, what we had in last June, some of the new faculties who joined their profession, they got opportunity to interact with person like Gaitonde sir. So they understand how to teach, then the way in which they have to take a subject, and those things are not available to few of us here. And I think we have to appreciate and we have to, what you call, as a reciprocity of love, we have to thank MHRD for giving this opportunity to the professionals who are going to join. Faculty are going to join this profession and then some of the newcomers in other institutes. Thank you.
That makes an important point. You believe that the newly recruited teachers could benefit the most because at the initial days itself they get some inputs. You agree with that? So maybe then when we select teachers for this workshop, this is going to be the last fully funded workshop. Subsequently, we are all reverting to a model of partial funding. So I'm going to put all the remaining money I have to use on this. That's why I suggested some 2,500 teachers, etc., could attend. But spread this news large and wide. And maybe when we select people, just instead of using first-come, first-served basis, we could apply some criteria and you may give some feedback on what could be that criteria. For example, we could give priority to new teachers. Ordinarily, we have been insisting that they should have 2-3 years experience of having taught that course. Or maybe we can make a sort of balance between both. You think that will be a useful thing? Any other comments, please?
Yes, please. Sir, my name is Praveen Sarude, and I am assistant professor in RC Patel Institute of Technology, Shirpur. It is actually in Dhule. It's a tribal area actually. It's north of Maharashtra. And whatever the cyclable team is doing, it's exactly that we required actually. In that remote area, we need such a talented people that we need to listen to them properly. I have attended that Gayathri sir's thermodynamics workshop, and we feel that the person having a near about age of 60 has a stamina of teaching 8 hours non-stop, then we feel that we should be like him. And it's our comment that if that be like a Gayathri sir, that we should be like him. That's it's a very good thing that a clever team is carrying out in this way.
I would like to add to the point which Sarodhya has raised. It's not only the stamina, it's a style of teaching also which is very important. And I mean, I have attended thermodynamics, I have attended heat transfer course, and now attending this one. The way in which the IIT professors deal with the subject, I mean, their methodology basically, they go in a quite slow fashion. I mean, they are never in hurry to teach. They never disappoint the question to the person if he comes up with a very maybe a simple questions. Even the simplest questions are answered enthusiastically by the teacher, and that is the kind of quality which normally, I mean, after having a 5-10 years of experience also, which we were missing. I mean, we were not having those kinds of qualities to deal with the questions or the methodology. So I mean, they are always cool, and in a cool fashion they go ahead, so it becomes very easy for us to digest the concepts. That is very important thing which we learn from these workshops especially.
When you attended from remote center, you were using, I think, AVU for that interaction. So from your experience there, the audio visual quality of interaction, etc., was good enough for you?
Yeah, there was some problem with the audio actually, but that I have already talked to Mukta madam. And there was kind of repetition in the voice, but that can be taken care of. I mean, even up
to... No, it's an important point that you make. What I propose to do is, so far we have been having interaction with the faculty members of relevant courses. What I'm planning is a 2-day workshop specifically for the technical people at your end.
Right, that will help.
So we'll call them here, we'll give them TADA, we'll house them here for 2 days. And we'll have an intensive interaction with our video, audio, video team, because there are small nuances which make all the difference.
Yes, sir.
And sometimes they don't take care of the proper equipment or proper setting. So perhaps that remote training has not been working so perfectly. Most places were comfortable. I asked this question because it has to be perfect at every place.
Yes.
You see, for those 30 teachers who assemble at your point, your place, for them, they are attending a course at IIT Bombay. So they would expect, you know, the same kind of clarity that if they were sitting personally. So this is an important point that you make.
Even if there is a problem with the audio at one place, it is actually replicated everywhere.
Yes,
so
yes,
that
yes.
That creates a problem.
So that is a good point, and we'll definitely take care of it. Of
thank you.
I'm Abdul Samad here from Hyderabad, Andhra Pradesh, and I'm from Uffakam Engineering College. I wanted to say that particularly in Andhra Pradesh, there are plenty of colleges. Like last recent 7 to 8 years back, we are having more than 500 to 600 colleges. And many of the teachers, like they are youngsters. Like so I felt that after like attending many of the teachers these programs, they are learning a lot, the methodology of teaching, the method of teaching and all. And apart from that, I wanted to appreciate the introduction of that Moodle, which IIT Mumbai have introduced.
Yes.
With that, I can say that like a teacher who questions, so all the person, those who are related to this Moodle, they are in a position to understand, and they are learning a lot. So I appreciate this Moodle is helping a lot to all the teachers, those who have attended.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I would suggest that you convince Mukamja College
sure.
to introduce Moodle as a standard feature for sure. managing all their courses.
Exactly. Sure.
That's what we do in IIT.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Thanks.
But the important key thing is that, you know, a complete distance education where teachers talk from here and occasional questions are asked by people alone would not have been adequate. It is proving useful because people like you are taking care of conducting the labs and tutorials in the afternoon. Because that is the group work which is done by those 30-35 people. And you will agree that while I may learn something from a lecture, but I assimilate it only when I practice some problems in the tutorial or do some lab experiment. And those cannot be conducted in distance mode. That is precisely the reason why I thought of this model, where it's a mix of this conventional classroom model plus the best faculty members. So you believe that the model is working, that is your labs and tutorial sessions, etc., can be conducted?
We have been running another program. You can think of it as a supplement to this kind of a course. It's called Ask a Question, where we meet the students. We have done it only in electrical engineering, because electrical engineering department was the most enthusiastic of all to participate in this project. Students post their questions on a forum, and the questions are answered in the forum. But for 1 hour every day, 1 hour a week, faculty members come. In fact, it happens every Thursday. It might even happen tomorrow at 4 o'clock, 4 to 5, by the electrical engineers, where the faculty members actually answer the questions posed by students. And the students can, it is also possible for students to ask live questions. So both are possible. So it is only answering questions of students. And students can connect from anywhere using the same software, AVU. Do you think such a thing will be useful for mechanical engineering? No, not just two of them. Everybody. Yeah. And of course, in the future, as we go further in this, the experts can come from various parts of the country. Experts are not restricted to IIT Bombay. They can come from other IITs, NITs, your own colleges, somebody who is very good, who has got the best teacher award, for example. Yeah. He'd be a great candidate.
In fact, one of the points that we had, I wanted to share this with you when I spoke to you, or when I'll speak to you on 16. But the fact is, this Ask a Question program can be conducted. After all, when you conduct a class, you are actually conducting Ask a Question program. But can you do that for those 30-35 colleges from which teachers had come to you? And can you use AVU? We can help you in setting up the AVU mechanism. And those colleges or those students who have internet facility, you can run an AVU session yourself. So if some of you would be interested, at least to try this out. So not every Thursday or something, but you can say once a month, we'll try it on a trial basis. So questions in, let's say, these three courses or whatever, you may name them. And you may say that students from those regions where they have AVU connection. In fact, it is not regional, because once you have an AVU connection, we'll identify you as a particular server class, and then anybody in the country can ask you a question, even I can ask you a question. Would you be interested in running such a thing? And it need not be a single teacher from a single college. A few of you could come together and say, okay, let's say we'll answer these questions in Hyderabad from Monday or some other place on another day. But the idea is to spread this philosophy of greater interaction between students and teachers. In fact, Mr. Sinha had asked me to create a list of 100 teachers across the country out of 9,000 who have participated in our workshop so far, who would be willing to come and face the students and ask the question. So you think such a possibility exists? Try and explore it when you go back. And those of you who are interested, on the same Moodle, you put up your comment saying we are interested, we'll carry this one. So, thank you very much. Thank you for spending half an hour extra on this, but we got some very useful suggestion. And I'll take this opportunity to thank Mr. Pradeep for personally coming here and sparing his time. Let's give him a big hand. Thank you.